since owning a track saw, I've almost abandoned using a table saw for breaking down sheet goods. For me, a track saw is more accurate, it's easier and safer to operate. So about 4 months ago, we started using the new Bosch 6.5-inch track saw. Bosch is relatively new. It's a newcomer to the track saw market in the US. However, its reputation in Europe has preceded it across the pond. The saw has a heritage derived from the popular and well-regarded Maffel track saws. And, you know, our expectations were high and the Bosch didn't disappoint. So the Bosch saw is made in Germany, and you know, a lot of the German companies, they're well known for their quality. This saw operates at 13 amps, has a no load speed of 3600 to 6250. It weighs about a little over 10 pounds and it has a spins a 6.5-inch blade. And from the first time I saw it, I opened the L-Box 4 that it comes with. You can just see the quality, the fit and finish of the tool. From the quality of the machine surfaces to the easy to read scales and the 12-inch long cord. When I fitted the saw into its tracks for the first time, super impressed with the precision of the fit. And that's between the body of the saw and the tracks. There was no runout play between the saw, the track, there was nothing. It was really tight. And you can adjust that. I tried to detect any relative movement by twisting the saw and I found none. This precise fit basically is due to two cam actuated adjustment knobs, and they're located on the shoe of the saw plate. And they basically ensure that precise fit between the aluminum extrusion and the saw. One of the keys to a successful track saw is the track system. So the Bosch track saw excelled in this area. Let's talk a little bit about the track. They're made from aluminum extrusion. And once, like I said, once that saw is on that track, there is a precision fit and there is no backlash. In addition, Bosch does a really nice job at optimizing usability features of their track system. For example, the tracks come with these installed plastic end caps. The caps help both an attached vacuum hose and the cord slide easily during the cut. It doesn't get hung up. Another example of excellent track features is the track connector. And that's the piece that joins two tracks for a longer track. The track connector puts pressure in this horizontal manner in a portion of the extrusions to ensure that the tracks actually line up perfectly. Bosch does this alignment with four cams on the track connector, two for each track. We even tried to misalign the tracks a little bit, and as we tightened the connector, it basically pulled it right back. It took out all inaccuracy. Super impressive, to say the least. Finally, I really like that the track connector does not interfere with the use of the clamps. They slide right over it. For dust collection, we easily fitted the track saw to a Bosch dust extractor, and the vacuum hose fit with no adapters. The combination of those two pieces of equipment basically produced a almost virtual dust-free environment. I've used it for lots of projects now, but after cutting four sheets of plywood down to 12-inch widths, there was almost no noticeable dust on my cutting table. There is a positive clicking hose port that allows the user to click the hose port to kind of hold the position, which is nice. It doesn't flop around. The saw has plenty of power. I could bevel through oak, mahogany, and doubled plywood. Let me see, it'll bevel from -1 degree up to 47 degrees, and the bevel cuts were flawless. No blade marks or variations in the surface of the cut. One of the things we did test is we tested the accuracy of the 45 degree factory bevel stop. Set the 45 degree stop, we checked it with a digital protractor. The factory setup was perfect. Dead nuts, right on. We also liked that the Bosch has a quick release clamps. It's an add-on accessory. These clamps have precise form and fit to the underside T-slot of their track system in the extrusion. We really appreciate how Bosch provides an easy way to actually see where those clamps go. There's like a little small notch at the end of the track. So you can do this, you can insert it without having to bend down and look around at the end of the track and find out where to slide it. It just slides right into that T-slot. The plunge mechanism on the saw. So Bosch did a nice job with this adjustment. The mechanism works by depressing a latch and then moving the depth stop to the correct setting. What I liked about this design is that the latch is big enough, or large enough for big thumbs to easily work. It was really easy to manipulate and operate. And the scale was large enough to see and read. Both metric and imperial scales are on the saw the body for the adjustments, and the adjustments in 1 millimeter increments. There's a red pointer to use for the depth, and this pointer can be flipped around in different readings. Why? Well, because Bosch designed the saw to be used with or without the track. So the saw has an optional rip fence, and this fence can be used for multiple cutoffs with no track. So as a result, Bosch provides you with an easy way to adjust for those times when the saw is going to be sitting on materials and you don't have the thickness of the track underneath. It's nice, nice detail, attention to detail, we like it. We actually pushed this Bosch saw a bit, and it has power to cut. It uses advanced electronics. It varies the power consumption to basically produce a constant blade speed under load. Even if you push this this Bosch saw past its limits, there's built-in thermal overload protection. It's going to cut out and protect the motor, and obviously protect your investment, because it's not a cheap saw. Getting back to the tracks for a minute, they are the saw, I should say, is compatible with competitor tracks. So the bottom shoe plate on the saw has a plastic strip that you can remove, and it will fit Makita, Triton, and Festool tracks, which is great. You can find the saw online at Ohio Power Tools. It sells right now with an L-box carrying case for $5.99. The tracks, you can get the 31.5-inch track. It's going to sell for about $79. 43-inch track sells for about $99, and the 63-inch track is about $129. Or you can get two 63-inch tracks in a kit with a track connector and a carry bag for $229. Oh yeah, and the clamps, they're gonna run you around $65. Look, pricey, but certainly an investment. Just wait until you see the build quality of this tool. Look, final thoughts on this saw. The attention to build quality, the build detail, the usability experience that Bosch put into the saw is impressive. I would put the Bosch saw up against a corded Festool for comparison. That's how I would compare. The Bosch track saw delivered precision, power, and is ideal in making table saw quality cuts in wood and wood-based sheet goods, such as laminated particle boards and plywood. The track guidance system provides exact fit, precision, and adjustments for position for end-to-end and plunge cuts. It's just a really nice system. It's a great shop saw, and we were impressed. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like up. Please consider subscribing. And don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. We'll see you at the next tool review. Take care.